Hello, I wanted to do just a quick little video on the determining opportunity cost question in the homework set because it's probably the most difficult question in there, and I figured I'd offer a few little hints for it. So, quick thing on opportunity cost. So, in economics, anytime you spend money for an action, economists would consider that a cost. So, there's no doubt that if you paid out, let's say, wages for workers, that would be considered part of a cost of maybe running a business. However, in economics, we always look at cost through the lens of opportunity cost. Basically, that every time you use a resource in one area, it could have been used elsewhere. So, by using a resource in one area, you're giving up an opportunity to use that resource somewhere else. So, really, a lot of times it shows up in the form of using up your time. So, for example, if you're spending time on this course, you're giving up an opportunity maybe to work or do something else. So the idea of measuring the value of your time is through the lens of opportunity cost, that hey, by doing this with your time, it cost you something else with your time. So whatever action you took, like let's say going to school, part of it is that your opportunity cost would have been maybe you gave up going to work instead. Okay, so let's take a look at this question. Now your question might look a little bit different. The numbers might be different, the names might be different, but the concepts are basically the same. So in this question, Janita basically is deciding to buy a suit, and there's different locations that she can buy the suit from. So here's her office. She can buy it at a discount price, but it's far away. Original price is a little bit closer. The closest place has the highest price. So then we're looking at, okay, well, what does it cost her to get the suit from the different locations? So let's just scroll down a little bit. So when we look at it, there's a few costs involved here. The highest price cost for the suit, which is $100, happens to be the closest since you would only need 15 minutes to travel there. Okay. Over here across town, it's a little bit lower price, but it's a longer travel time. And the lowest price is the farthest away. So when we look at what does it cost Janita here to buy the suit, you have to look at the cost as the price that the person would have to pay for the suit, plus the other resource which is given up, which is the time. Okay, so 15 minutes there, 15 minutes back, it would be 30 minutes of travel time to go to the local department store across town. Looking at it this way, 30 minutes there, 30 minutes back, and it would be an hour, and so forth. So what's the true cost of the suit? So let's take a look at what Janita could be doing instead of shopping. And this is kind of the key component. Here, right, you can see that she can make $56 an hour. So she has to take time off to purchase the suit. So if she's spending time shopping for the suit or driving to the location for the suit, she's giving up time working. So for example, if she went and purchased the suit, paid the price of the suit, but it cost her an hour of time total, then the total cost to her would be the fact that she had to give up working for an hour, which would have been $56 she could have earned, plus whatever she paid for the suit. So figuring in the value of time component here. So let's look at this a little bit more. So scrolling down, and one other key thing that you have to note is that it takes her 30 minutes to shop. So regardless of the location, it takes her 30 minutes to shop. And then you have to figure out the travel time as well. So for this one, the local department store was 15 minutes there, but it's also 15 minutes back. So for the local department store, there's 30 minutes of travel time. Then there's also 30 minutes of shopping, which is an hour total, which would be what? $56 she could have earned. So what's the opportunity cost right here for the local department store? Well, it's $56. Because it takes her an hour worth of time to shop and to travel. All right, and then she would have to pay $100 for the suit, so that would be $156. So hopefully you can figure out the other answers for your questions because of this video and your own intuition. It's kind of a neat little exercise because we've all dealt with these things where something might be a lower price, but you have to use more time to get it, and kind of really valuing what a true cost is in economics. And cost isn't just money that you spend, but it's also the value of your time. It always includes opportunity costs.